Hello everybody, this is John Hardy bringing you the business tip of the day. Transparency. This is what we do in business on a regular basis. We think by telling the story of the business to everybody, we give away the kitchen sink. Then we get feedback and we wonder why the story has been misrepresented, reinterpreted, and it's not the message you were giving out. Here's the problem. You're giving away too much information to people in your organization, and they could be suppliers, they can be clients, they can be staff at various levels, they can be board members, etc. And they don't have the capacity for the business that you have. And here is the challenge for you as a business owner, is learning to discern who needs to know what level of information. Because I know this from being in barbecues, listening to stories that people have about business and how they misinterpret and misread what's really going on. And I love it because I get a chance to ask questions about, do you understand that maybe this happened, or do you know that that could be going on, or are you aware in business these dynamics take place? And most of the time people do not know the variety and the dynamic and the complexity of business. You understand it. You have a coach in the room like myself, and we're working on the complexity of the business. We're going into the detail and the fine print of what's actually going on with the finances, with staff hire, with those staff that are going well and those that aren't doing so well, with the metrics and what the story is being told to you there. And you know that information. And what it is, I know the motivation for you to tell the story as a business owner into the workplace with your staff is you want to get them on board. That is not going to get them on board. They don't have the capacity and they don't have the ability to understand the complexity of the issues that you've grown the business into, and now it's quite an interesting dynamic. That's why it really is important to have a coach in the room, so we can talk at that peer-to-peer level who understands those dynamics. And, you know, I've had 16 years of experience as a coach, talked to lots of businesses of all sorts of shapes and sizes and dynamics, and I understand the questions that you're asking. And so that's the level of questions that we need to engage in. So what the challenge for you is the transparency levels. And there could be a really cool way of doing that, like we do delegation levels of where we're going to spend money, who's authorized to do what. It really could be a fantastic idea for you as a business owner to think about transparency levels. And so who do I want to actually share this with? You know, with they know the intimate details of the business, to when I'm having a staff meeting, hey guys, we're about to launch into a new location. The business is doing great. So there's different ways of telling the story, encouraging so your staff know what's going on, and being aware and informed and casting the vision and lifting their spirits and motivating them, encouraging them, all those kind of dynamics, but you can do it in much more general terms without giving away the kitchen sink, which is often what business owners do. And I tell them to do this. Zip it. Shut up. Stop talking. Because business owners often talk too much, say too much, and they say it to the wrong people. And so it really, really is important for you as a business owner to understand your motivation to be transparent is a good motivation, but it's discerning, creating your transparency delegation, your transparency worksheet, who you will share what with, and to know why you're actually going to do that with those people, the context, the complexities you actually want to share with them. And the higher it is up, the more complexity, the lower it is. You just want to say good things, powerful things, strong things, but less complexity, and letting them know that they are part of the journey. Because often I've done this over and over again. I've told business owners to stop talking. You're saying too much. People don't understand it. Because here's the deal for most of our people who work for us, is they really just enjoy coming to work, being a part of a dynamic business, hearing the stories of successes and developments and growth and the challenges and difficulties as well, and working with you to do all those dynamics. But they want to go home at the end of the day and they want to spend time with their wife and their kids, or go and go for a swim, or go and get the boat out, or have a barbecue. And they want to do those things, where at night you're thinking about another way to do business. You're doing your strategic hour, which I've talked to you about. You're spending time reflecting. You're going over the books. You're analyzing the figures. You know, you would spend more time in that space and you want to give it away. Let me tell you, stop doing it. It's not the power that's really going to help you. And it really will help you greatly to say, using the principle, say less, not saying more. This is John Hardy, bringing the business tip of the day for you. Understand transparency. Stop saying too much. Great working with you. We'll be back again to help you understand powerful transformational principles to help you do business so much better. Thank you for listening.